Hi, my name is Hannah Kirkpatrick, and I'm a program intern at the Vermont Historical Society. I am thrilled to share this item from our collections with you today. This is a pair of ski boots that was owned by Henry Johnson Perkins of Faiston, Vermont. He was a ski instructor, an avid skier throughout his life, and he was a member of the 10th Mountain Division. These boots were made by the Peter Limmer Company, which was founded in the 1920s when Peter Limmer Sr. came over from Germany, where he became a master shoemaker. In 1950, Peter Limmer moved his family to New Hampshire, where the family continues to make custom hiking boots to this day. So while the ski boots we know today are made of hard plastic with a soft inner lining, and they come all the way up to your knees, these boots are made of leather. And this was the stiffest material that would have been available to use. And it only came up to your ankle, as you can see here. So the binding would have come around the front of the toe. There would have been a cable that went around the back and a leather strap over the front of the boot here. That would have kept the boot on the ski. The skis would have been basically wooden boards, but it would have been enough to keep your boot on the ski and get you down the hill. Over time, ski boots became stiffer and they became more protective of the lower leg, and also skis developed so that you could go faster. This binding was developed in 1928, which coincidentally was also the year that the earliest steel edges for skis were developed. These were the best boots that money could buy back in the day. Perkins started using them in the 1940s, and you can actually see on the bottom of the boots, there's a marking that says 1947, and then one that says 1987. So he used these boots throughout his life until he stopped skiing at the age of 93. Perkins also used these boots in training at the 10th Mountain Division at Camp Hale in the Rocky Mountains in Colorado. Before World War II, the ski industry wasn't so much an industry as just people going skiing. But after World War II, vets of the 10th Mountain Division, like Henry Perkins and his friend Sewell Williams, who donated these boots, really started to develop the ski industry in Vermont.
Because the 10th Mountain Division had a lot to do with Mad River Glen, did it not?
Well, it had a lot to do with all the ski industry and bringing the ski areas to be more active, opening up ski areas, opening up ski shops. All the ski industry, I would say, probably because of the 10th Mountain Division, probably put them 10 years ahead of what would have happened if it hadn't been for the 10th. That many men from the 10th Mountain Division of World War II went into the ski business.
The ski school at Mad River Glen was run by a veteran of the 10th Mountain Division, and Perkins and Williams both opened lodges near Mad River. Perkins was known as The Perkins, and it has since undergone a name change, but still exists today.
They said, you don't want to settle up here. Go down to Mad River Glen where it's just starting, and you'll be one of the early starters. And that made sense. I came down here, and this property, Route 17, went up to Mad River Glen. And there was an old farmhouse for sale right next door, now Millbrook Lodge. They sold it to me for an exorbitant price.
Thank you for joining us today. If you'd like to find out more about these boots or other items from our collection, you can follow the Vermont Historical Society on social media or check out our website, vermonthistory.org.